The sea is fascinating because on the surface it's beautiful and it's also ever-changing, and then when you look down below there's actually so much more going on than what you would initially see with your naked eye. My name is Jack and I'm from Davis, California, and I'm studying marine biology. I was a bit apprehensive about moving all the way across the world at first to start a completely new life in a place where I didn't know anyone in a completely different climate. However, as soon as I came here, I've met so many students here, and although we have such different backgrounds, at the end of the day, we're all studying the same thing, we're all students, and we all have so much in common. So growing up, my grandparents had a little cabin on the coast, and I've been able to spend my summers there. And I have so many fond memories, being able to just have a short drive down to the water to be able to go surfing, exploring tide pools. There's just something about the sea that is so captivating. Within marine biology, we're able to study lots of fish dynamics, fish stocks, fish populations, and see how all of this actually matters for human use and for the natural environment. And it was in my senior year of high school where I took a course in environmental science, where I thought it was just absolutely amazing that I can spend a class that gets to be able to study atmospheric science and nutrient cycling and pollution and stuff like that. So then when it was time for my master's education, I felt like Stockholm University was such an amazing place because there's so many big parks and natural areas, and it's really amazing to be able to hike through all of these and never have to worry about trespassing. And one of my favorite things about Stockholm is how much water is integrated around the city. I mean, it's a city of all of these islands connected by bridges, and there's fish in these waters. The buildings are just amazing. Like in the United States, our history only goes back a couple hundred years, but now that I'm here, everywhere I go, I'm constantly reading the signs that tell you about the history of this building or of this bridge or of this road, because I find that stuff so interesting. For me, there's something about being able to go out and study a body of water and figure out which sort of lure and at which depth and what color and what retrieval speed that can be used to catch this fish is very rewarding. And then to be able to release the fish so it can swim to be maybe caught again another day or just enjoy the rest of its life. And I'm fishing in the middle of downtown Stockholm, which is so weird because I'm in such an urban setting. My drive is to be able to better understand these ecosystems, and by better understanding them, we can actually make some positive change to help preserve them for the future so that we can have these beautiful landscapes.